إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل غوى وإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا إن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وإن خير الأمور عوازمها والشر الأمور محدثاتها كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد يقول الله عز وجل في كتاب الكريم بعد الأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم ما بعد Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. We praise Him. We seek His assistance. And to whom? To Him and only Him do we turn in repentance. We seek the forgiveness of Allah from the evil of ourselves and from the evil of our actions. And whomsoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever is led astray, there is no guide for him. We all testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. And we all testify that Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam is the final and beloved messenger of Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to Yawm al-Jum'ah, the best day of the week. And alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, today is the 22nd day of Rajab, 1440 years after the hijrah of beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, which means just a few more short weeks left inshallah ta'ala to the blessed month of Ramadan. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to experience the month of Ramadan once again. Today, I want to discuss, we always gather here on Fridays. We always come to the masjid on Fridays for a special day, for a special celebration. And we come here a lot of times and out of habit maybe. We do a lot of things just out of habit and we may not understand, or we may need a refresher on some of the things and some of the beauties of this day. So to understand the blessings of this day itself, there's many blessings that many of us may not recognize or maybe may have forgotten or may have never heard of before. And some of us, you know, we don't understand the etiquette of the day of Jum'ah. The day of Jum'ah. Right now, as you see the place of the here, you see up here, it's not full yet. The masjid is not complete. Once you listen to this khutbah today, about the blessings and the etiquettes of Jummah prayer, from this point forward, there should be a reminder that the masjid should be full right away as this adhan is completed. Everybody should be inside of the masjid. And we'll go through all of these details. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put a lot of blessings on the day of Friday. The day of Friday, so many blessings that we can't even count all of them. But of the blessings of Friday, on Yawm al-Jum'ah, Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala created the first man, Adam alayhi salam. The first man was created on the day of Yawm al-Jum'ah. Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala created the creation starting with Adam alayhi salam, and it was completed and finished on the day of Jum'ah. Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala allowed Adam alayhi salam to enter into paradise on Yawm al-Jum'ah. Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala allowed Adam alayhi salam to enter into this dunya, into this world, on Yawm al-Jum'ah. Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala, when Adam alayhi salam and his wife had made a mistake and asked for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala pardoned Adam alayhi salam on Yawm al-Jum'ah. On Yawm al-Jum'ah also will be the end of time. The trumpet will be blown on Yawm al-Jum'ah, and the day of resurrection starts on Yawm al-Jum'ah, the day of Friday. So
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed this day. There are many blessings in this day. Many of the greatest things have happened on this day. As you can see, creation, all of us, we are all creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that comes from Adam alayhi salam. All one Father. Our Father was created on this day. And then think about when this world starts. So we think about him being kicked out of something. Friday should be thought of as something that is a beginning. The Prophet ﷺ reminds us that this ummah of Muhammad ﷺ was last, but yet will be first. What does that mean? We know of one of the meanings, that we were the last ummah created, last ummah to be sent. And in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be the first to start it. But it also has a greater meaning for Fridays. The Jews, the people who follow Judaism, they will be celebrating their tomorrow, their day tomorrow, their commemorative day is Saturday. So for themselves, they chose Saturday. The Christians, they chose for themselves the day of Sunday. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the beautiful gift of Friday, and that we are before Saturday and Sunday. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. So we are before them. Friday should not be the end of the week. I understand that we live in North America, and in North America, this is the end of the week. In TGIF, thank goodness it's Friday for another reason, because the weekend's upon us. But thank goodness it's Friday, because it's the best of the days. The Prophet ﷺ said that this is the Sayyid. Friday is the Sayyid of all days. The best of day, all of the days. This is the beauty of this day, my Ikhwan Islam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has preferred us over all of the other ummas, over all of the other ummas that have come before us. They're not different religions, right? They have created their own religions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's religion is one that we all believe in. La ilaha illallah. The messengers have changed. That's why I'm not going to say to them that they're different religions of Allah. It's one religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The religion that we see in existence today is the change from the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where they have deviated from the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Yom al-Jum'ah, it's a beautiful day. It has a lot of commemorative activities, but we make it a habit. So we shouldn't treat Friday just like a Thursday. Hey, one more day of work week. No. Yom al-Jum'ah, the best day of the week. And you see, whenever I make the introduction to this day, I say, welcome to Yom al-Jum'ah, the best day of the week, because it's not my saying. It's not because I like it. It's because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that this indeed is the best day of the week. This indeed is the best day of the week. On this day, we should take extra precautions and extra care of ourselves. We should treat it as a special day. This should be treated as a very special day. So you should come early in the morning after Fajr prayer. You start reciting Surah Al-Kahf. Even your Fajr prayer is different. If you're following the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Fajr prayer itself has a Sunnah of itself, that you should be reciting certain surahs in the Fajr prayer, in the fourth prayer. Surah?
Sajda.
Sajda, sorry.
Sajda.
Surah Sajda and Surah Insan in the second rak'ah, inshallah. Those two surahs should be recited in the Fajr prayer. This is the beginning. And we should know that the beauty of this day, Yom al-Jum'ah, the beauty of it is a person who dies on the day of Jum'ah or the night of Jum'ah has a blessed death. It's a good sign. It's a good sign of God. This is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He fills out the soul of a person on Yom al-Jum'ah. Beautiful sign. Now, one question that we have to ask, what is Friday night and what is Friday morning and Friday afternoon? So we are right now on Friday morning and Friday afternoon going into it. Friday night is not tonight. Friday night was last night. Our night starts, or our day starts at Maghrib time. Today at Maghrib time it will be Saturday. It will be Saturday. So when yesterday, Thursday, when Maghrib hits, that is the day of Friday for us in Islam. So that night, in any period of that 24 hours, from that night to Maghrib tonight, if anybody were to perish, they have a good sign of that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. Allahumma ameen. Ikhwan Islam, on this day, you should take the ghusl of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
in the morning time, if you just take a regular bath, you go into the shower, just get wet, soap up and walk right out. No, there's a special, there's a ghusl that we should make. Ghusl is very simple. People make it sound like it's very complicated. Ghusl, you make the wudu. You make everything of the wudu. So you wash your face, wash your mouth, wash your nose, wash your face, arms up to your elbows, masha. And then you go into the shower, wash the right side of the head, left side, right side of the body, left side, right side, left side. And the only thing you leave outside is if the tub is not full of water, you wash your feet in there. If it's not full of water and it's not dirty, you wash it there. Or you come out and you wash the remaining portion of your feet in the sink. Very simple. So we should take a bath every Friday. Every Friday morning, it should be a bath. It should be a bath. In that way, you do wash your hair and head. Complete bath from head to toe. In this day, you cleanse yourself and you purify yourself. You take your fingernails off. If they have grown a little bit more, if you grow a little bit slowly, then do it every other week. But on this day, you should take care of it. Any hair and belong in places where they don't belong, they should be taken care of on a weekly basis. So the pubic hair that we're talking about, in the private parts and in the, under your arms, this should be taken care of. You should pay special attention to making the recitation of Surah Al-Kahf anytime after the Fajr prayer, up until the time of Yom Jum'ah, and there's other traditions that say you can make it after Jum'ah prayer too. But the best thing to do is to recite Surah Al-Kahf, even if you recite just a small portion. You can't get through the whole Surah, recite Surah Al-Kahf. Perfume, make yourself smell beautiful. Make yourself feel beautiful. The Prophet والسلام, used to put on the best dress, so make sure you dress nicely. That you're not wearing ripped clothes, the clothes that were from last night, nice and pressed, iron, beautiful clothing, pressed. You're looking like you're trying to go and get married. Something like you're going to a beautiful function because you're going to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa ala inside the masjid and listen to the khutbah and listen to the prayer and pray with the people. Being a community, reciting together, making Jummah prayer together. This is the beauty. You want to make it and make it as beautiful as possible. Leaving the business, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Jum'ah, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, idha nudiya lis-salati min yawm al-jum'ah, fas'aw ila dhikrillah, wa dharu al-bay'. He said, hasten. Once you hear the adhan of Jum'ah, and so since we live in North America in non-Muslim land, you're not going to hear the adhan. But you might hear the adhan on your iPhone, or on your watches, on your iPads, computers. Once you hear that adhan, it's time to hasten. But that doesn't mean. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, don't run to the masjid. Because when you try to run to the masjid and hurry up, you're out of breath now and you're trying to catch your breath and you're trying to, no. Hasten means wrap up whatever you need to wrap up at work and cut off the time. Put it on your schedule as an appointment. Right now on my email schedule, I have from 12:30 to 2:30, I am not available. This is the time that's blocked off. Not one person in my office can try to schedule an appointment with me because I have another appointment. A very much more important appointment with praying Jummah prayer with my brothers on the day of Friday. This is much more important. And this is what we should do. Make sure that you come together. Jummah, it's a gathering. Jummah, so to have a gathering together. This is going to happen all the time. Every Friday. And that's one of this. This day of Jum'ah is considered to be another type of Eid. Eid can have two types of definitions. We know Eid al-Fitr, inshallah, in a couple of months we will be celebrating Eid al-Fitr, which is the celebration of the month of Ramadan. And then we know Eid al-Adha, where our brothers and sisters all across the world will be making a Hajj. And we know that Eid. But Eid can have another meaning to constantly come back. Jum'ah prayer. Jum'ah, Friday. It's repetitive. It constantly comes back. It constantly comes back. That's one definition. And the other definition is, of the other two Eid, where we're happy, we're celebrating, we're commemorating, we're celebrating the achievements of everyone. In the month of Ramadan, inshallah, where we fast the whole month. And we pray all night for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah gives us a day of celebration. This is the beauty. And then Eid al-Adha, where we're celebrating the people making that once in a lifetime obligation of going to the Prophet ﷺ's home, land, in Mecca, in Medina, and making our pilgrimage, our Hajj and Umrah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our deeds. On this day, making dua, there are two special times. The strongest opinion are, there are two strong opinions of making the dua. Today, inshallah ta'ala, when I sit down, at that time,
when the imam, when the khatib, he sits down after the first khutbah and he sits down, that is a great time to make dua, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the dua, whatever you ask for, in two types of periods. One is this period, by the strong, one of the strongest opinions is from the time the khatib sits down all the way to iqam as-salah, including the dua of the khatib. So every khatib, usually when he's here, he makes a dua. He makes this dua because this is one of the times of acceptances. And the other time of acceptance, as we know, is the latter time of Asr. And as we can see, Asr comes in at 4:34, after Asr, before Maghrib time. So the last hour. So 7:16 is Maghrib. From 6:15, 6:30 onwards till the end of Maghrib time, till the beginning of Maghrib time, is another period of acceptance. So we should make dua as much as we possibly can. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the beauty that he brought to our religion and the constant struggle that he brought, that he went through, he's made a request of us as well. You know what his request is? Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To make salah, to send salah on the Prophet alaihi wasallam. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. To make as much durood as you can on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. From the time Thursday night begins, meaning Thursday night is our Friday night, from that time, all throughout the day, try to have your saliva and your mouth wet with sending salam to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Constantly say sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Certainly, constant salah on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is a request that he's made of us. So much so, of other things that you should do, and this is what I want to talk about. The people who are the most blessed in the Yawmul Jum'ah are the ones that come earliest. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam communicates to us, tells us that the people who come here the earliest, they're going to get the reward of the camels. And the people who come later than that, they get a cow, the reward of a cow. And then the people who come after that, they get a reward of sheep, and so forth. Until the imam, the khatib, comes forward, the last person to enter at the time when the imam comes is an egg. What does this mean for us? We don't know what these animals are, and probably most of us don't understand in terms of animals. This just means the greatest of the rewards. So if we were to equate what a camel costs, this is what we're talking about. The reward is immense for coming early, and the people who come late. And what happens? The angels are writing down in their scribes, in their scrolls, they're writing down all the people, and they have taken attendance already of the people that have come all the way until the time of the after the time of Adhan, they roll up their scrolls and they also put it away. And you know what they do? They also listen to the khutbah. So it's imperative for the imam, the khatib, to make the khutbah extremely special, something that is enlightening the people, something that is going to bring the people, something that is beneficial to the people, because even there's another whole being that is listening to us today, are the angels all over the world listening to the khutbah as well. And the people who did not get onto the register by the time of Adhan time, they're not on those scrolls. So it is imperative that we try to make it as early as possible to the time of khutbah. Another thing that I want to bring to your attention, we always mistake that the khutbah, meaning the Jummah prayer, and the Dhuhr prayer, they're substitutes of each other. Because if you miss Jummah prayer, then you pray Dhuhr. It's not a substitute. We have five prayers in our religion. One of them being Dhuhr, and the other four you already know. And then there's the extra special prayer of Jummah. It doesn't take place of the Dhuhr prayer, it is the Friday prayer. It doesn't take place of the time either. So if this masjid and this community decided that they are going to wait for the 1:15 time of Dhuhr to come in and pray and start the khutbah at that time, and all the masjid agreed, again, I'm saying this, listen to me carefully, I'm not saying that this is the best time. If you agreed, because the Prophet ﷺ made the prayer, meaning the Jummah prayer, that includes the khutbah and the salah, before the time of Dhuhr even entered into. Some people say, oh, no. We have to wait for the Dhuhr prayer to come in. So that's after the sun reaches its zenith and crosses its zenith. But the Jummah prayer can be prayed at that special time. Remember, it's a special gathering. It's a special gathering every Friday. So again, if the people of the masjid, the community agrees without causing any fitna, if this is going to cause fitna, alhamdulillah, we're good with 1:15, And we'll end at 1:45 inshallah ta'ala. We're not here to create fitna for anybody. We're letting you know that the other times are available to you as well. So if you want to have the khutbah and the salah at 12:15 to 12:45 for the entire year, it is allowable inshallah ta'ala. Just pointing it out there. But if you want to keep it around the time of Dhuhr prayer, because it might cause conflict, it might cause fitna, people are going to start causing problems, and they're going to say things because they have no knowledge of this. Without knowledge, they're going to say, no, this is how we do it. Alhamdulillah. This is how you do it. This is how we keep it, inshallah ta'ala. So these are some of the etiquettes of the Friday. Taking care, making extra dua. Charity, the Prophet ﷺ said that the charity on this day is better than any of the other days. The charity, the money that you take out today when you leave the masjid, whatever you donate in the week, try to make this a little more special and give a little bit more, because there's more special, there's more specialness in giving charity on the day of Friday. Try to take care of the masjid. That doesn't mean you don't take care of the other days of the week, but try to do more in this week. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa guide us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa allow us to understand the beauty of our day of celebration. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa allow us to implement and understand the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfiru li wa lakum wa li sa'iri al-mu'minin wal muslimat fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة المتقين والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد ما بعد. As we stated, that the beauty of this day of Yom al-Jum'ah and coming away from your businesses. So when we said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa'ala has said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُوذِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. To listen to the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa'ala, which is the khutbah itself. Which is the khutbah itself. Whoever misses the khutbah has missed Jum'ah. Whoever misses the khutbah has missed Jum'ah. Just in case, even so, some people say, no, just make the salah and you're still good, inshallah. No. You have to listen to the khutbah. And the khutbah has to be in the understanding and the language of the people. There are certain people that say the khutbah can only be in Arabic and that's the only one that can be accepted. If people don't understand, what is the benefit? It has to be in the understanding of the people. The khutbah should be in whatever language you best understand. If there is a certain language, Bengali or Urdu or Spanish, whatever the language. Here in America, we speak English. English is our natural language here. So we speak in English, so people can understand the khutbah and be able to relate. Because this Friday to the next Friday, remember I said that this is a beginning of the week. The reason why we have the khutbah is what can I improve upon and what can I do better until next week. The blessing of this day is so much so that the alternative universe, Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala, just like you ever have a barbecue and you have charcoal in a barbecue and you're lightening it, lighting up the charcoal to heat up the chicken and to cook it real good, in the fire of hell, the coal that's there, the charcoal, it's being sharpened and it's being intensified, the heat is intensified. But because of the beauty and because of the blessing of Friday, Allah subhanahu wa jalla wa ala even allows the fire of hell to cool on that day. So much so, the paradise. Why are we supposed to close up our businesses? Why are we supposed to take time off our employers and come to masjid to pray Jum'ah? Because this is an alternative. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you to leave something, there's something waiting for us in place. Because people don't know this problem. But in Jannah, in paradise, there's a souq. There's a marketplace that will be open on Fridays for everyone to shop. For everyone to go and have a beautiful gathering. In Jannah, there is no more salah, there is no more jama, there is no more dua. It's, everything is fun. All of the restrictions are over. This is why you work so hard to reap the rewards in this life. Because you want to have that next life where you don't have to do any of this. You have two options in the next life. Either you go to Jannah and live a
worry-free life,
or you go to the fire of hell. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all.
May Allah protect us from the fire of hell. Say Allahumma ameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantee us and enter us into the highest level of Jannah of Firdaus al-A'la. Ameen.
Don't be shy, Ikhwan Islam, to get into the ameens and say, Ya Allah, please accept, because this is the hour of his acceptance. This is the time of acceptance. So constantly make dua to Allah. And if you hear something that appeals to you, say, and the khatib is making dua, say ameen. Say ameen. So in the souk, when the wind comes and blows, everyone is becoming more beautiful. And so much so, when they return back home in Jannah, in paradise, to their family members see each other, wow, what did you do? You look so much more beautiful and so much more noble than before. And the person who went to the shopping center and came back to home, he's going to say, same with you, you look so much more beautiful and more noble. This is the blessing of Allah.
If so much so more, there's more, Ikhwan Islam, there's so much more, I can't cover it in a half an hour. There's so much more, but I want to tell you what more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offers on Yawm al-Jum'ah. On Yawm al-Jum'ah, in paradise, Allah gives you more. We get to see the face of Allah. We get to see the face of Allah.
We get to see the face of Allah. What more rewarding experience can you have to see the face of the Master who created us? What more rewarding experience can you have that you went all the trouble that we went through, waking up early in the morning to make fajr, constantly battling meetings, and constantly battling the wives and children, and going through our prayers, and making the prayers, and raising your children, and taking care of your children, and having hard-earned money, and giving it to zakah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you can see it. So you can see it. This is the beauty of this day. Everything that you do, every struggle that you have, and if you think just 2 weeks ago for our brothers and sisters that were killed inside of that masjid in New Zealand, they were here worshipping Allah with their backs turned to the shooter. They were sitting like this. Either they were sitting or they were praying. And he shoots them up. Instantly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guaranteed them martyr. They become shaheed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept their martyrdom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept them being shaheed. What more beneficial can you have? What more benefits can you have than knowing that you had a good death at the end? People who are sitting there just to pray to Allah, they saying La ilaha illallah, they saying Allahu Akbar, and only praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and some crazy man comes and shoots them. Think about it, Ikhwan Islam. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah, how fortunate are those people. They have a good ending. This is what we all hope for and we wish for and we cry for. Ya Allah, give us the best ending in the world. Ya Allah, give us the best ending in this world. That way, when we stand in front of you, Ya Allah, without any hisab, without any accountability, Ya Allah, us to enter into Jannah al-Firdaus al-A'la with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to implement the Fridays as a beautiful day, as a beautiful day of commemoration on a weekly basis, and make it special, Ya Ikhwan Islam. I would appeal to the board of this masjid, to the people who run this masjid, and to the community members of this masjid. Make it special. Do special things on Friday during the Jummah prayer. Whether you give out something, be even a little cup of water. You want to give out some food, have something afterwards. Make it a special gathering, because the people are gathering for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this day has a beautiful meaning. This day was chosen by Rabbul Alameen. There's no one else who's choosing this day for us. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not choose this day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose this day. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless this gathering. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give us the best in this dunya, the best in the akhirah. Save us from the fire of hell. Give us the highest level of Jannah al-Firdaus al-A'la with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma aghfir lil-mu'mineen wal-mu'minat. Allahumma aghfir lil-mu'mineen wal-mu'minat. Wal-muslimeen wal-muslimat. Al-ahya' minhum wal-amwat. Allahumma innaka afuwun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'fu 'anna. Allahumma akfina bihalalika an haramika wa aghnina bifadlika 'amman siwak. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ahu. Wa arina al-batila
الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم أيد الإسلام، اللهم ثبتنا على الإسلام، اللهم نور قلوبنا بنور الإيمان، اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا، ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. اللهم لا تجعلنا من القوم الظالمين، اللهم لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين. اللهم هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.